Ruth here, and this is a lot of stuff, but it was on a sale. It was the last day in the summer sale, which was 20% off, and it had some other discount on top of that as well. I think it was like a double sale plus the 20% off with the summer code. So I got this lot. So this is all from Crafter's Companion. I hadn't bought it from them yet, so I think there was supposed to be some sort of discount for a fudge purse kiss. I'm not sure because I didn't actually notice anything. But then it's gotta save £10 or dollars on the next order of over 50. Use code that. One per customer, one use per customer. Excludes August and September launches, July shootings, clearance items, third party brands, gift cards, and design pay. And it expires 17th of September. Good. And it's not September yet. Still August. Be fine. Well, I probably won't find things. I mean, I've got lots of things in my wish list already anyway, to save for later. And the goal, I guess I'm gonna tell you, is £46.28. So a huge bargain on these bits, not this one, but these two. Like a set of three, and set of how many that is. Okay, so first up, we have this thing, which is a heat and mold stamping foam, pack of four. That's at £4.66. So, I was curious, because it says that you can heat one side of the foam, press foam into your chosen item, such as embossing folder, and use your favorite media to stamp your own designs. Oh, that was interesting. So the foam looks like this. You can heat it up, and I got a heat gun over there, but I'm not going to really do it right now. But, four. Let's see. Select the item that you would like to use to create an impression. Heat and mold. In the heat and mold stamping foam, use a heat tool to heat one side of the foam until the foam is moldable. Keep heat tool moving throughout the process. Press the heated side of the foam into your chosen items as texture to create an imprint on the foam. Apply your desired ink to the foam. We recommend spritzing the ink with water to achieve best results and repeat impressions. Stamp the foam onto your surface or project. If you've spritzed the ink with water, you can achieve a number of repeat impressions without the need to apply more ink. Clean the ink from the foam. Once cleaned, return the foam to its original form by repeating step 2, so it's ready for future use. So that's great. It's reusable. Because like, I've got a few embossing folders, which I showed you in the last opening video, and I can't really use them yet because I don't have a die cutting machine. So I thought that'd be cool to use. Perfect for creating textured background stamps. Also moldable, so it can be used time and time again. It's great. I had a hunch it was reusable, but I don't think I actually read it anywhere for some reason. Anyway, so that's that. that's pretty neat. So here we have the Crafter's Companion, the stamp cleaning solution. So spray the solution directly onto the surface of the stamp or use it with the Crafter's Companion stamp cleaning station. I decided not to get it so I can get this one, because this one is just $3.99, and if I got it with the platform, it would have been about $15.99, and I can easily just spray this over a towel or something, so I thought, yeah. To scrub the stamp until the ink has been removed, re-dry the stamp, and it is ready to use. Our all-purpose stamp cleaning solution has been created to work with most types of ink, including dye-based, pigment, and hybrid inks, and it is suitable for using with all of your rubber, polymer, and acrylic stamps. Use the stamp cleaning solution together with our stamp cleaning station to ensure perfectly clean stamps every time, is what it says. By the way, they're on Facebook, Pinterest, Instagram, and YouTube. Search Crafter's Companion. Not sponsored or anything. But next up, we have this one. It's from their Once Upon a Time series, Signature Collection by Sardines. This one is the Make-A-Wish 7-piece clear acrylic stamps and dye. The dye is for the fairy, and it was £4.66. So let me show you what it looks like. I mean, I guess I could just show you there. I don't wanna. Okay, so here's the die for the fairy, and on the back there was a. Here's the sparkles. I mainly wanted to get it for the sparkles. And the wispy bits. So I thought that was cool. May all your wishes come true and make a wish. I quite like the sparkles. It's like, I thought I could, like, you know, could use it for cards and stuff. To get a little magic-y feel to it. So that's that one. And these three were part of the Rose. That's only listed as kit. Blah blah blah. It's either kit 2 or 17. So I didn't actually write out the bundle name, but this is from the Rose Garden series, another signature collection by Sardines. This is called Fancy Floribunda, and it is 2-piece, 4 inches by 6 inches, which is 10.1 centimeters by 15.2. I might as well show you. Very strong tape on this one, so I might have to just cut it open. Unfortunately. I wanted to keep it nice, But anyway, yep, this is a metal die there. So like, it's two pieces. So I have to wait to get my thing, die cutting machine, so I can use it. That's it for future stuff. So here's another die cut, metal die. The die cut is the thing, is the paper. The metal die. So thinking of you. I thought that was a cute one. I'm not gonna bother opening it, I mean, it just looks like that, so. And here is another one, which just looks like that. As you can tell, I like roses. Roses and cherry blossoms and hibiscus are my three favorite ones. So this is that set, which I believe is 6 pounds 61. Maybe. These prices don't have the something missing, isn't there? Because this set costs 11 pounds something. The closest part shows is 9 pounds 32. So I guess this list here doesn't show the VAT. Maybe. I don't know. But anyway, that was the rose set. Now this is a lot. Put the bigger one in the back so you can see everything better. Okay, so this one is an 8-piece die set, precious peonies. That's what they'll look like in the end. That's, yeah. So I don't actually have any flower dyed metal dies, so I thought that'd be cool. Do need to get a rose one or something. Create stunning 3D peonies with our precious peonies metal die set, perfect for many occasions. So next up, we have a stamp set. And this is Lumiere's. And lanterns stamp set, perfect for creating cards and gifts for all occasions. So it's these two. I mainly like the font for Happy Birthday, Thinking of You, and Hello. I'm not too big on the lanterns, but I mean, it could be useful for something. I like the rose. But like, this was in the set of these, the Bell Countryside. Okay, so next up is Grand Frame stamp and die set, 6 pieces. So you got the die for the main thing there, and you've got a enjoy every moment, forever and always, for a special friend, and you make me smile. You know, whenever I see that forever and always, I always think of the Always and Forever from the originals or Vampire Diaries. For some odd reason, I have no idea why, it just stuck in my head. Really weird. But yeah, though technically, Always Forever flows off the tongue more than Forever and Always, I think. It just blows better, really. That's my opinion. Okay, next up, we have another stamp and die set. The die is the horse. And this set's called Equine, which means horse, really. Elegance. Some words are really annoying to pronounce. So it just says, thanks so much, and just a note. Which those two are good sentiments to have. It's also got a basket with some flowers on it. Has another stamp. But mainly it's the horse stamp this is for. It's nice that it's not just the horse stamp. Okay, and last but not least, here's an ornate lace metal die for like an inch piece, you know. It's very cute. I wanted to put like that, let's get going. Oh, that's really nice. So that's the small stuff out of the way. And the big thing. I'm gonna put these in a different spot because I don't have room. So I'm gonna put this off to the side. And this is a small version. And it says £13.49, which I'm pretty sure I paid about 16 something for. And it is Crafter's Companion. Cutting platform, professional, small, guillotine. And I thought it was nice because I don't actually have a good trimmer, cutter, whatever. Okay, it says hardened stainless steel blade, integrated scoring board functionality, which is good because I don't have any scoring anything. An easy to grip handle, finger safeguard protection, measuring guide in metric and imperial for accurate sizing. I think I've read everything. Cut and score with ease, / portable design. And it's good that it's a small because it's good I didn't get the big one, besides the big one didn't have any sale on it. At like about $39.99, but this one actually fits on the desk, which is good. That's a bonus. Oh, here's the picture on the back. So the platform is 6.25 by 8.75 inches. Let's see. Top and bottom of the trimmer unit for accurate sizing up to 15.6 centimeters or 6.25 inches. It's got where the finger guard is, scoring tool, basically it's a bone folder, isn't this what it's called? Score lines embedded into the base, 0.25 inches apart for precise, accurate scoring in seconds. Safety and care instructions. Blade is very sharp and can be dangerous. The tool is not to be used by anyone under the age of 18. Blades can be cleaned and wiped using a damp cloth along the side of the blade. Always dry thoroughly after cleaning. Do not submerge in water. Always handle with care. Store in a cool, dry place out of reach of children. Which is a basic thing. Okay. So, since it's sort of almost coming apart, on the bottom, I'll open it in the bottom. Let's move this. Over there. Okay, so not that it matters, but this is what it looks like on the bottom. Don't think it really matters. It's got some like silicone feet for like a, I guess, a nozzle thing. you say past quarantine away before I believe your move. So it's got the scoreboard here, and his bone folder. I like that sound too. Bone folder there. It's got Crafter's Companion imprinted on it. And it's got the centimeters and inches right there. Got this guard and ooh, that sound is nice. Okay, so if you remember from the previous video, I've got my cute little bunnies. So let's just cut off the whole entire bit because it's not gonna Let's listen to the sound now. That is lovely. You know what? Unfortunately, since a large one has an extendable piece, this one doesn't because it's just a small. So this is just do it enough. Not very good at this. Is it going to be good? Hang on. That's why I probably need an entire ruler, but I don't have one, so. Yeah, I guess. So technically not as supposed to use it, but just do it this way. I'm just gonna wind the crease up. and it's not white. Level. So we'll trim off a tiny bit. See how good it is at trimming tiny bits. Very nice, very nice, very tiny. This is fun. I'll have to actually cut it out myself, but I'll use this as a scrap thing to, I don't know, but it is very nice. I faded many, but my markers are down there. I can't bother to get so. Throw this bit away, because like for this, put the scoring tool or bone folder back in here, so I don't lose it. Yep, clicked into place. Place that down. So I just cut that out. Put it there. Color it in. Wait until I buy a die cutting machine and cut it out like that, or fussy cut it. Either way. And then I mean, I could make this into two small cards. You know, like, or just trim. Because like that is put it on the long side as well. So you trim the bottom anyway, so because it is a large size. Right? So it should be about that size. Wait a second. 0.5, 8.65, 5.6.5. Well, we'll do 6. Line it up to 6. Then snip off the rest. That cut nicely. There we go. It cut very, very, very tiny. Which is good. Probably shouldn't really talk today, but anyway, that's the card size, I guess. So like, would you normally do it on the smooth side on the back, or have this side on the back? I don't know. Because this card stock is smooth inside, textured on the other. So I don't know if you can really see. It's because I like more teeth.
Because what I used is just some cheap stuff.
good. It's a 30 pack of Let's Craft, A4 white card, 200 GSM, 30 pack. Got this at the works, I think. I think anyway. But yeah, that's what I got. So put that down. Safety first, people. So yes, I've got a card base. Let's see what happens. This is great. That's nice. I think, is it straight? Well, it's straight on both sides. Just feels a little more needs to trip. Is that box straight to you? My depth perception, and I guess straightness, is not as straight as I'd like. But anyway, so if I wanted to put something on there, obviously I wouldn't be able to do it on that side. But like, stamp something on there. Why don't we stamp something on it? For funsies. Let's see. Hopefully that one's in the second box. Hopefully. This is blank. So I can probably still use that maybe. Keep that. The second box, that which I don't want to say. Now let's stamp something, shall we? Put the stamp on. I guess we could do a basket. I could go in today. Basket or something on here. And you're thinking basket maybe. Let's do this. Swap out my stamping platform with my guillotine. that over there. Clean off the desk some more. Oh, this has gone past 35 minutes. Okay, let's hurry then. I could use this for a different, thing too. I wonder what it would be if I stamp on the... Though this one admittedly is bigger than the piece of paper. So I'm tempted just to stamp it on here, and if I need to, I didn't do stamp seasoning. Just quickly season up, I guess. Do like that. Season stamps. Might as well do all of them. Thank you. smaller. Okay, so yes, I didn't put enough ink on there. That looks it. Yeah. Yeah, I did too many at the same time. Let's see. Maybe it's this side in the top. Maybe this side of the cardstock shouldn't be used. because he's not going anywhere. Is he doing any different? And draw a duplicate of prisoner here. Well, let's see. Right there, where the leaves are, and the leaves up here. We'll just give him like an ear hook. That's right. Now I've gotten curious. So, we're basically cut out later. And here is this thing. Okay, cut this out and put it on the side or in the middle. And I've like sent it down there. You know what I mean. I'm curious to try out something. Well, that's strong, that is. So we need... well, thinner than that. Hopefully my battery doesn't die before this. So, perfect. this one. This one has fun on that side of the construct, I guess. So it's just the shiny side, smooth side, just doesn't stamp up. Okay, so I've been blabbering on. So thank you for watching. Next time for more, ring the doorbell for notifications. Over and out.